Thank you. studying the overtone series that are coming out out of one specific instrument and sharing it amongst an entire ensemble of different types of instruments. The music is extremely interesting, subtle at times, and then also at times of being very apparent of what's going on in terms of this interaction. The fantastic musicians of the Contemporary Music Ensemble, who are now So George Haas, who is considered one of the premier spectral composers, now Kertag, who is amongst the next generation of composers, an Israeli composer who further investigates the many different aspects of overtones, harmonics, both in the composition itself as well as how instruments react with each other, to each other, and within an ensemble like this. And I think with the introduction of the Haas composition, where he's also, of course, we started off with one of the most beautiful Renaissance motets, and then expanding, using that as the basis for his own harmonic language, we also going to hear very much the same idea, but not using something that's familiar to us, but right from the get-go, something that's extraordinary, unique in the piece that is now representing the youth, the direction of this compositional style with this great, great composer. And I think we got everybody back almost in a minute. So thanks so much. And now for the Kertag.
Thank you. For the last selection, I've asked Dr. Marilyn Nonkin, who is both our fabulous leadership in our piano program and as well as director of music and performing arts professions here at Steinhardt, and is considered one of the world's foremost authorities and experts in spectral music, in spectral piano music, and especially this last piece where we're celebrating the composer's 80th birthday. Marilyn was in France with the composer, had the opportunity to meet him, and as well, we will be recording this piece in several weeks. So can we welcome Dr. Marilyn Nonkin, please? Thank you.
Hello. Thank you so much for coming tonight to listen to this fantastic program, and I'd like to thank the wonderful players and Jonathan Haas for putting this together. I think I approached Jonathan, maybe he said this 6-7 years ago, to do L'Origine du Monde, so it's really a dream come true to play this piece. I just want to say maybe a few words about Dufour and his music, which is so rich and so colorful. In his music, he's playing with music, with notes and sound, like a painter plays with paint and colors and hues on the canvas. And so it's not surprising that in many of his titles, he refers to paintings by Titian or by Courbet or Jackson Pollock, because he's thinking about sound like color. And he's exploring in his music ideas that other painters and artists explored in their works as well. So as we're listening to these sounds and what they evoke in us, whether it's kind of enchantment or confusion or frustration or fascination, we can think about what these sounds mean to us, and also we can think about these other works of art, like Courbet's L'Origine du Monde, what those meant to people when people encountered them and how shocking or surprising or provocative those works were. So Dufour is kind of having this double play with our imagination, in that this is a piece of music which is a piece of music to be listened to, and it's also a piece of music which is commenting on other works of art and what it means to engage with another artifact. So just I want to thank you all so much.
Thank you. Thank you.